Hey there, Jeremy Weiss here with Weiss Tech Hockey, and in this video I wanted to show you the Kronwall hit on Kyle Palmieri. This happened in Game 4 of the Stanley Cup Playoffs 2013, and obviously we've got Anaheim versus Detroit. So what I'm going to do is let you see the clip in full motion, full speed, and then we'll back it up and really dissect actually what's going on here. And then I've actually got a few other examples from different clips that kind of show the same thing. So let's go ahead. First and foremost, we'll watch it in full speed and then go from there. So as you can see, it's a dump in. Detroit's using a bit of a 1-2-2 forecheck, and there was the hit. So let's back this up now, show you kind of in slow motion. In case you miss it, happens right down at the bottom part of the screen here. So let's keep it going. Okay, so Detroit, like I said, they're using a 1-2-2, and they set up what I call a kill zone. Boom, right there. Okay, I've mentioned this in a few of my other videos, but what we're talking about with the kill zone is, first and foremost, let's just kind of show you, we've got F1 swinging in, he puts the pressure on, and in this case, they actually go against the initial pressure and break out strong side. So breakout's coming out this side, this guy comes through, but now as we progress up the ice, let me just clear off some of these lines here. Okay, as we progress up the ice, watch what we've got here. Okay, so we've got, this is where I'm talking about the 1-2-2, and this is similar. We talked about this a little bit on my trap clarification video. The same concepts apply in like the 1-3-1, but basically what we're talking about is setting up a kill zone where we've got a guy angling the play. So we gave them the board side breakout. Now we're going to angle the play up the ice. Okay, and as you can see, it's going to be this guy actually. I kind of drew the wrong line, but the concept is you're going to angle the play up the ice and then set it up where your defenseman can step up and make the hit. And because the way that they angle, we've got one guy angling this way, the other guy's filtering back, and that makes it so that even if the defenseman does step up, it's not gonna leave you vulnerable for an odd man rush after the fact. So I know I kind of drew my lines a little crazy there, but you're gonna be able to see the concept as we push it forward here. Okay, so here's the angle. As you can see, this guy's pushing through, this guy's filtering back, and now we've got Kronwall just licking his chops, ready to step up and make that big hit. Boom. Okay. And because of the way that we've got the secondary, F2 and F3 filtering back, it allows for that defenseman to step up. And even if, you know, on the odd occasion that he does miss the play or miss the player, you've still got two back checkers on their way back. So it's a very safe play in terms of, you know, not leaving yourself vulnerable for an offensive threat afterwards. All right, let's take one more look at it from a different angle now. You can see still the same concept. We've got pressure angling up ice. Kronwall steps in and the guy's just got nowhere to go. And that's why we call it the kill zone. You set up an angle, set up the pressure where there's just nowhere else to go and the guy's forced to take that hit. So that is the Kronwall hit. Like I said, it all takes place, it all is possible because the forechecking pressure sets up for this kill zone where we've got two guys angling back, making it so that the puck carrier can't cut inside and Kronwall can step up and make that hip check. Now, what I want to do now is actually clip over. As I was watching this, I was actually watching this on YouTube, there were a few other videos that showed up in the related feeds, and one of them was Kronwall's top 10 hits. So I'm gonna just kind of let it play through, show you what these top 10 hits look like, and we're gonna highlight a couple things along the way. But notice the pattern. Every single time Detroit does it so well, their forecheckers are the ones setting up that kill zone, which allows Kronwall to step up, really lay these guys out, and it's an intimidating forecheck. So let's go ahead, we'll clip over to Kronwall's top 10, and we'll just let it play from there. We'll be right back. So that's how to set up a Kronwallian hit. Obviously, there's a few more hits than just 10, but you can see a similar pattern over and over and over with those Redwings forwards setting up that kill zone and letting Kronwall step up and make that big hit. Very effective play. Obviously, the Redwings have done very well, and definitely, I think, something we can learn from that.